So what about your progress? I mean, anyone has any opportunity to hands-on with those things? Any problem you faced? We can discuss. We have 5, 6 minutes, and probably we will start on that. So if you have any kind of problem, you can discuss with me.
Hi, Subrata. So, Prabhat here. Actually, we have. I'm finding it a bit complicated to install the AngularJS. So, my current Node.js version is a bit older. So, based on my current setup, so is there any guide you can provide that I can follow to
So
for old?
you need to maintain that node version in your system, or it is okay that if you upgrade node version.
Actually, we have in OUP different platforms created in AngularJS and Node.js. So we need multiple version to run those. So is there any way?
We have NVM. We have NVM. Through NVM you can actually change your node version, and you can have multiple node version in your system. So whenever you work with any kind of application, you can change your node version, and then you do your functionality.
Okay, so
NVM
there
has.
will be the procedure to switch between node versions as well.
Yes.
Okay, thank
Same like a database, like you use node version,
you.
so it will trigger, and then whatever application or whatever code you will do, that will run based on that node version.
Thank you.
Hi Subrata.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, I have installed the Angular and Node as well, but Node module folder was not created in my file.
Module, I mean,
That you have now in your Heroes folder, you have a node module. So that was not generated in my code.
so how you install Node?
A link which you have given now, there from there I have installed node.
No, you need to create an IT ticket. There may be a restriction from the global protect side,
I
so
think yes. I think we need to install node differently. Yes, system from IT only, we have to install that node part.
So they will actually put an exe or maybe msi for into your system, and from there they will install the node.
Yeah, I think we have to explicitly get it installed first, then only we can do other things here.
So you need to raise
So
an IT.
I will do uninstall all those things, and then again I will generate a IT ticket for node.
Yeah.
So they will give me a node access. Actually, I have a VS 22 2022 access. Well, I'm in .NET programming now. Hello.
Yes.
Okay.
So first create an IT ticket. So probably if you create IT ticket today, they will come tomorrow morning. Okay. Rest of the things you can do in your own. Okay. So create an IT ticket so that early you create, and it will be easy to attend the
Yeah,
process.
sure. Okay. Thank you, Subrata.
Anyone has any kind of problem? Are you gone through the RxJS operator I have discussed? You have any questions? Do you understand the difference between promise and observable?
Hi Subrata.
Yes.
Yeah, I read documentation about merge map and switch map, but I couldn't understand it.
Okay. So have you tried to explore in the Google with the example?
Yeah, they all look similar, so I couldn't understand it.
Okay. But the example, any one of you actually able to understand merge map and switch map? Hello? No one understand merge map and switch map? Hello.
Yes, Subratan. No, I couldn't understand.
Okay. So the example I shared with you, where is the problem? Can anyone open that example and share with me? Share the screen. Hello.
Yeah, hello. Actually, I am looking onto that section, but still not completed to understand that section so far. So that's why I'm not sharing my answer at this moment.
No, I just want to, I mean,
Yeah, I am
can
actually
you open
studying.
that link? Can you open that link? Can any one of you can open that link that I shared? Yes, yes,
The document
yes.
link you have shared, so
Yes, I'm talking about that link. No, document link is separate. During the training, I have shared one link.
let me share my screen. Is it visible to all?
Yes.
Yes.
This is where I just started. I mean, started my studying, and still continuing this process. Sorry. Hello.
Yes.
And till now I haven't completed to study these things so far. And basically, you provide some links like this one and as well as these two, but I compared these two first, and right now I'm trying to access, I mean trying to understand this merge map and tap and map, etc. at this moment.
So I have shared one RHS link also, right? RHS operators.
Yes, RSS operator, yes. That I haven't recorded. I'm stopping my screen sharing. Any problem?
No problem.
Okay, thank you.
क्या आज होगा कि नहीं होगा?
Just a minute. I have shared a couple of links in the chat. Okay. You can able to explore the example. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, Umar.
So, I mean, we have left here with this particular stuff, right? Now today we will continue from so we will create a message component over here. So first let me generate this component. And next target is similar like our Heroes component. We will take it and put it into our app component.html file. If we put over here, this message component should have something. Message box. Some text is showing. Now I am going to generate a service. Open message service there. Now we are going to inject this service into our app hero service.ts. So this is the first message we are getting, that hero service faced heroes. So from where this message is coming? Hero service faced heroes. So first of all, what I have done, let me tell you a couple of things. So I have created one message component, right? And then we have our app component, forget about this. Then we have our message HTML message component. So in that message component, we are calling a service. Okay. This is a message service. And earlier what we have hero details component, okay? So that details component was child of hero component. But this message service, message component actually residing at the same level of hero component. So it is not a child component. It's a sibling component. How you can understand sibling component? If you go into that, these are sitting in parallel. So these are sibling components. Earlier we have parent-child relationship. Now we have sibling components. So we have our own message component, and then we have created one message services. This message services basically pushing data from different sections. So it is there in the very beginning when your page is loading. It is pulling that data, that hero service actually fetched the list of heroes. Okay. So this is the one thing. Now in the second part, if I click on the hero detail component, you can see that heroes component selected hero ID 12. Okay, so we have injected this service into my hero service. The hero service, just one thing you have to mention, that this is a private to hero service. This message service is private to hero service. If I move into message component, you can see this is a public. So you have to think about what is happening. So people who came from JE, Python, PHP, .NET, you can understand the private and public concept over there, right? The same thing happening over here. So whatever interface you are getting, we have hero service that is actually pulling our all records. Then we have our message component. Abhi band kar do isko. Message component or TS file, we have nothing. Just we have included this. This is a blank dump component. Okay. Then we have message service. We have two methods, add and clear. Add will pull records, okay, and clear will clear the message. So for example, if I clear, the message will be cleared.
But Subrata, from where we are calling that add method?
This way. When you click on any list, any row, we are calling that specific records.
On click, okay. It is calling that add method and adding to the message service.
Yes. So message service has a push mechanism. So basically, it's a public service, but it is somewhere, it is private. Okay. So Hero service basically consuming this message service. So whenever, when you use this Hero service is getting used when we are pulling data, I mean list of heroes. So this is an ad. This ad basically call a push mechanism over there. And from that push mechanism, you are getting there. So we have, I have created one single service for cross communication. Okay. Now my understanding is I am sharing data between multiple components. There is a app component, there is a message service, message component is there. And this message service is private to Hero service. And at the same time, if I go into the Hero's component, you can see this is in private to Hero component also. But to use that service in different component, we have to make it public. That is the thing. So we are calling it from two portion. One is from the Hero service, that is getting data from there, and also from the Hero component. When we click on specific heroes, the Hero details component actually coming out, and it is actually sharing data that time. So this particular service, so what I want to say, in Angular we have two ways of communication. One is a parent-child communication that you have seen, and this is a, this communication is through services. Okay, so you have created one service, you can inject those services into the respective components, you can use those methods written in the service in multiple components to get and set your data. This is a cross, or we can say that sibling component communication happening. So anyone has any question?
So Subroto, by making that message component public, we can reuse that component in other sibling components as well, apart from the heroes?
So message component, we do not have anything. If you go into that message component, do we have anything? Yes, we have. We have this particular HTML. Because of this particular HTML, we are using this message services, or we can say that message component. But
so this HTML is getting rendered through the message service, right?
Yes, this message component actually receiving, consuming the service.
So what I'm saying, that the Hero component and the message component, okay, so those are in as a sibling. So by making that service public, are we saying that we can reuse it in the different sibling component as well?
Yes. Yes, we can use it in any component.
Okay.
Anyone has any question? So two types of component communication we have shared. There is another way of component communication happen, that is called through an observable. That is, we called a subject or behavior subject. Okay. So there are four types of subjects available in Angular. One is the subject, another one is the behavior subject, third one is the replace subject, and fourth one is the async subject. Okay. So these are a little bit tricky. So right now I'm not exposing these things. I'm just giving you some sample that two sibling components can share data either through a common service, or through by using subject or behavior subject or whatever we have. Okay. So whatever we have learned, you refactored the hero service class, you registered the hero service as the provider as of its service at the root level, so it can be injected anywhere in the application. You used Angular dependency injection to inject it into a component. You gave the hero service get data method and asynchronous signature. You discovered observable and RxJS observable library. You use RxJS offer of function to return an observable of mock of heroes. The components ng oninit lifecycle hook calls the hero service method, not the constructor. You created a message service for loosely coupled communication between classes or components. Hero service injected into the component is created with another injected service, message service. So hero service itself is a service, it's also consuming in another service. Okay, so a service consuming another service. So far so good, right? I mean, we have no problem with that.
Yes.
Regarding observable, yes. As you know, this is written as a string of data. So how do you implement pagination on that? Like as for now, we are expecting the total list of data in a variable as an observable string of data. But if we want like pagination, like 3 or 3, 5, first in first bit 5, then 5, like chunk of data, not all of data in one variable of this, then how can we implement?
So in Angular, when we start working with Angular, we generally do not focus on those minor things. Okay. So there are ways you can write your custom function to handle paginations and other stuffs. Okay. But in Angular, most of Angular people have the library. Like we have Angular Material, PrimeNG, Bootstrap, NGX libraries. So these libraries have inbuilt components and business logic over there. They have created pagination component and text box, drop down, and other things. So when we include those libraries and we pass our data set, it will automatically show the pagination and other things.
Yeah, so but using observable, we can't implement the pagination, right?
So everything, say for example, observable means you send and request to a backend API, right?
Yeah, yes.
Backend API probably write a select query and you put it into a JSON and return you the JSON. The front end is consuming the JSON. Okay. Now, when front end is consuming the JSON, it may array, whatever it is. So whenever front end actually consuming the JSON, it consuming as an observable. Okay. So plus minuses, I have already told you. So you have the data in your end. So maybe 50 records, 100 records, whatever it is. Now you need to plot that data. Probably you think about an array, you have 100 elements in there, and you need to write your pagination logic onto based on your data.
Okay. So
now my question, I got your question, what you actually want to ask. So your question is, I mean, this stream of data that is coming, right?
Yes.
So for this stream of data, observable basically passed out a couple of information with us. So debounce is one method, note it down, debounce. Debounce is one method that is available in the RxJS. The library that I have shared with there, you can also search the debounce for there. Okay. And there are ways, couple of ways that basically can play the stream that is coming.
Parsing those streams.
Yes. So I'm sharing this information so it will help you. Just you have to read it. There are examples. We have given an API call and other things. And now the how they are actually managing. This is basically a very good example in case of when we are writing any search logic over there. Okay.
Yes. From that observable data. If you want to search.
But there will be a lot of RxJS operators involved over there. Okay. So you have to first clear your RxJS logic. Because RxJS is the backbone to write quality code in Angular. If you do not have control in RxJS, do not understand, spend more time with RxJS. Okay. Because RxJS is the, because it will save a lot of your coding. Otherwise, you will try to think about your jQuery JavaScript pattern. You will get data, then probably you will write a custom function that will modify your response as per your need. But RxJS has lots of flexibility to play with those data. Okay. So now we are going to add some navigation over in Angular. So let's start with that. So we will, because ng generate module app routing, because this file is already, I think, exist over here. App routing module is available over here. So we don't need to run this command. Earlier version, we do not have this routing thing. We generally used to run these commands. Right now, we do not need to run this command because it is ready-made available with the latest Angular. Okay. So you can see these things. So whatever it is like now, let me explain those things. So this is the main routing file we have in Angular. Okay, so we have to, so right now the URL you can see, right? This URL is there. And everything we have plotted into our app component. Now, if in our case, you have multiple routes over there, then it will be difficult to manage with you. So this router module and routes, basically managing the Angular routing. So Angular routing has, let me first plot this thing, okay? Then we will discuss. You can see one thing, this is very important. I'm just plotting this hero component, and hero component is not available over here. So automatically, CLI basically gives me an indication that we can import this hero component. So when you click on this add, it will automatically import this particular stuff. So this is path heroes. Okay. So path heroes. Okay. Now we have our router outlet. So what is happening right now? So all the information gone, right? So we have added one link over here. If we click on these links, then all this information will come. So right now we have implemented this routing thing. So let's discuss about routing. So now let's move into this routing module. First, you have to understand the routing concept very clearly. Routing is basically navigation. You have home, about us, component, and blah blah pages over there. So whatever you have, you can take this routing over here. When this routing basically matches, okay, then matches with whom? Matches with this link. Angular do not have any href thing. Okay, Angular doesn't support any href. In apart from that, it is generating a router link. When a user click on this particular router link, you can see in the browser that localhost 4200 hero's path is coming. When you click on that, so it basically gets matched into this particular route, and then this particular component is getting called. That is called the concept of routing. So this router module, like ng module, I have discussed. Ng module is, I mean, responsible for handling every module in the Angular application. Same thing happens with this router module. So we will discuss about couple of things in Angular, like with the that is associated with routing. One is preloading, another is the lazy load. These are the two very important aspects. Preloading is not so important, but lazy loading is very important. Okay. So, I mean, whatever we have done today, that is, I mean, end of today. Okay. So, do you have any question? From tomorrow onwards, we will add multiple routes over there, and we will move ahead with this particular stuff.
I have a question here. Yes. For the routing. So is this routing is preloading or lazy loading? Because I'm asking why, because
it is eagle loading.
Okay.
Yeah. So whenever you have in everything in Angular, by default it is given one shot. I mean, you have 15 components in your application. All you have loaded from here. Okay. So when Angular try to load or bootstrap the entire thing, Angular actually loads everything into here. Okay. And this particular stuff basically, I mean, takes us very poor performance of Angular application. That is called eagle load. For small application, maybe a 3-4 HTML pages Angular application, that is fine. I mean, eagle loading is fine, because they are not dealing with many data and other things. But when you have a very huge logic over there, then we try to distribute our business logic into lazy loading concept. That basically loads each module one at a time when user clicks on that particular navigation. Say, for example, we have hero component, we have message component, we have hero detail component. So here, first time we are loading this hero component. When this hero component is getting loaded, right now with the eagle loading, all stuff's actually getting loaded, okay? So hero message, hero details, everything over there. But we can segregate our business logic. When we click on any route, that respective module or that respective component would be loaded. So I will show you how to do that. But one thing I can tell you, this is the router outer link. So you can see that I have removed that selector, right, app heroes. And that selector I have replaced with router outlet. So what is this router outlet? Router outlet basically deals with the dynamic loading of components. So today I have only heroes component to show. So that is only heroes component by default it is showing. But tomorrow when we have 4-5 links, so I click on the heroes, so heroes component will be loaded. I click on a link, then a component will be loaded, then b link, that b component will be loaded. So these two components are getting loaded dynamically into the router outlet. Okay. So I mean, today is, I have to stop over here. I have another meeting. So if you have any kind of question, I can answer maybe in within 4-5 minutes.
All right, super.
Yes, sir.
All right. I have one question over here. Can you show edge screen? Coding it.
Sorry, you can ask.
Yes. So, like you route, you write over, like routing, like so below that you we have another component like new message. So while it will be called.
Because these are the sibling components, right?
Mm-hmm.
I told you by default we do not create any routing for messages.
Yes.
So that's why I just put it over here. And this is an example I want to give you, mm-hmm. that I create a route only for Hero's component, not for the messages component. Okay. So that's why I take out the Hero's selector from the app component and put it into the routing. So okay. When we have our routing for messages component, then we can take it over there.
Okay. So like while we write in browser only as a like localhost and 4200 only. So that time the new message will be called.
Now everything is getting called in one shot. Everything, whatever code we have, whatever components we have, everything getting called in one shot. That is called the eager loading.
Okay.
So unless and until we structure our Angular application in a lazy loaded format,
mm-hmm.
By default it is eager loaded.
Okay.
Okay, so tomorrow I will more explain about the life cycle of routing. So routing also has certain kind of life cycle that I didn't create into this particular document. Okay. So I will explain a couple of things about the life cycle, I mean how this request cycle actually works into the Angular architecture, that I will mention to you tomorrow. Okay guys, I think we can stop today. Thank you. Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.